think about the aesthetic zone, when you're dealing with problems in the aesthetic zone, everything is critical, everything is important, because everything is visible. Anything that you do, the slightest mistake, the slightest problem and complication is going to show and may cause your treatment to fail. So when you're thinking about replacing a tooth in the aesthetic zone, let's say a central incisor, the three most important things doctors are concerned with, number one is the interproximal tissue or the papillae, having some symmetry with the adjacent tooth, and having good tissue contour, and that basically improves the emergence profile of your implant restoration. If you have all three, you're doing pretty good. Now, a lot of the doctors are very concerned with all three of them, and in this presentation, I'm going to show you a couple of techniques how you can come on top. Now, really, where we are being tested in the aesthetic zone, you don't want to have a disaster where a tooth is cracked subosseous on a patient that has very thin tissue, extremely thin tissue, barely any attaching keratin as gingiva. And this patient came in with mobility, and we know why. You would like to predict and plan your extraction, and we know it's going to break. That's the obvious. We know that we need to prepare our Benex system, no doubt about it. Now we're staring at the hole, and we're not that concerned. We're not that concerned because I can connect my extraction screw very simply without damaging the tissue. And Ambrish, I'm not using luxators. I'm using the Benex system exclusively for these types of situations. Connecting the cables, connecting the pulley system, and this root is going to come out actually easy, no problem. And you don't need any special skills for that. All you need to do is engage the extraction screw along the axis of the root, connect all the parts, rotate, and just do it. Now look at the video that I have on the Benex system. You'll learn about some of the complications. I don't have time to get into this right now. This patient's dentist asked me to preserve the crown and send it back because he would like to bond it as a temporary. So what I did, I actually sent back the crown, but I cut off a little part of the root. And the reason I'm doing that, what I'm doing here, I'm processing this root fragment, this dentin and cementum, putting it into a dentin grinder, okay? It's a specialized grinder for teeth. Okay, it's called a smart dentin grinder by a company called Cometa Bio from Israel. And I'm pulverizing the root and creating a particulate graft that is now called a dentin graft. Now, what's in there? The majority of this material is dentin because the majority of the tooth structure is dentin, but we obviously have a little bit of cementum. If we didn't need the crown, I would have pulverized the whole tooth. I would have had some enamel as well, which is basically hydroxyapatite. And that's all good stuff. It's pulverized into small particles of the ideal size for a bone graft. It's not a bone graft, it's a tooth graft, but don't forget we also have some organic tissue in there. And for that purpose, we need to use a dentin cleanser to clean out all the organic material. It's a process that takes about 10 minutes. And then we use a buffering solution to buffer the pH. In order to enhance this graft, I'm going to add some PRF. I'm going to add some metronidazole, basically adding some metronidazole from a capsule. I'm going to add the particulate graft. I'm going to add PRF. I'm going to add some metronidazole, mix it all up, condense it into the socket, compartment grafting using a PRF plug right on top, two little X sutures, and basically you're done. So really, doctors, look at this. Something that should have been very complex in terms of the extraction process, in terms of handling the site, is facilitated with the Benex system. And I wanted to just to mention the advantages of dentin grafting. In case you're asking, the doctor from India is asking, is this really osteoinductive or conductive? Is definitely any bone graft is osteoconductive, meaning allowing the bone-forming cells to migrate upon and create a good scaffold. But in reality, if you think about it, dentin has growth factors and a lot of other things that participate in the healing process. But just if you think about the concept of grafting a tooth back into its socket, if you think about a tooth that came out and you're placing it back, the reason these things work is because the tooth gets ankylosed. So guess what happens? Each particle gets ankylosed with direct bone apposition on the graft. If you think about it, dentin and bone, the alveolar bone, have been together all the time, and it's a perfect marriage between two structure now in a different form and bone. And if you think about each and every particle, let's say a few hundred particles all being ankylosed into the socket, you're getting the most stable bone graft and the better quality. And in my experience, now using it now for a few months, I'm getting great implant sites with very good stability. Now, you can also use it.